This episode of the Game Over Greggy Show is brought to you by Movement Watches. Movement Watches was founded on the belief that style shouldn't break the bank. The watchmaker's goal is to change the way consumers think about fashion by offering high-quality, minimalist products at revolutionary prices. With more than 500,000 watches sold to customers all around the world, Movement Watches has solidified itself as the world's fastest-growing watch company. Movement Watches start at just $95, but at department stores, you're looking at $400 to $500. Movement figured out that by cutting out the middleman and going online, they can get rid of all that retailer markup and just get you the watch you want. Get 15% off today with free shipping and free returns by going to movementwatches.com/Greggy. That's MVMTwatches.com/Greggy. What time is it? It's time to step up your watch game. Now, they said it was time to step up your watch game. I added the what time is it thing at the front because I thought that was funny. movementwatches.com/Greggy. What's up, everybody? Welcome to the Game Over Greggy Show. I'm one of your hosts, Greg Miller, alongside the producer slash seducer, Nick Scarpino. What's this shirt?
This is a Death Eater shirt. Got this in London when I went and saw the Harry Potter.
How am I just seeing it now?
You've seen it once before.
Really?
Yeah.
Really?
It's a dope ass shirt.
Yeah.
Thank you. I've been here when
they redesigned the Death Eater logo for that show, and this is it. And it's dope.
Why did they do that? It seems like
2017.
It goes along with the whole the art direction for the whole show. They did all the logos and the house logos and all that stuff in this more like angular style. It's really cool.
Oh, sure. Okay. They want to have
like a halo emblem.
It does. It does remind me of that. Yeah.
Over there, the pure one, Tim Geddes.
Alfredo's old team was Team Kitty Cowboys, which I appreciated. It was a kitty with a cowboy hat. Don't need to be too complicated.
You sure?
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
It's great. What do you mean, am I sure?
It could be complicated. You seem like a man who likes a little bit something complicated.
Oh, yeah. No, but it's like this. It's like minimalist, just kind of like just shapes. You know,
it's
a
this,
kitty yeah. shape of a face and a kitty.
Okay.
Now, I had the opportunity to get one of the house shirts while we're here, while we're talking about this, because you seem
sure.
so very interested in this.
Yeah.
But I decided not to because
why?
This is a really strong logo.
Now, is the real answer because D wouldn't let you buy that many nerdy things?
No, actually, the real answer was because they were an odd heather gray. And I was like, oh, I do like heather gray. But then I think they have like the pocket on it. And I'm not really.
You're not down?
I can't mess with that.
Well, also, did they run out of sell out of your house, Ravenclaw?
How dare you? A and B. Yes. No, I think they had plenty of Ravenclaw. They always have plenty of Ravenclaws. They always fill out a Gryffindor and Slytherin.
So we just flew to Australia. So I was on a really long flight. And on that flight, I was working, doing a lot of organization of my notes that I've taken over the year. And one of those notes was do a short called That's So Ravenclaw with Nick.
That's pretty good.
That's really
as far
good.
As that idea went.
No, that's great. We'll write that right
And
now.
Over here, the last Long Island boy. Colin Moriarty.
Really, I didn't like that
was
one.
Awful.
This I liked all of the other ones.
I mean, hey, I perfected it, and then if people say it was getting boring. Now they get bad stuff. That's what they get.
I really like that.
Thank you. What's going on with the Islanders? Are they moving away? Are they not? What's happened? I was in Australia. I see you put out a tweet or something. They're moving away.
The governor of Connecticut wrote a letter to the ownership saying that they can move there if they want, to Hartford.
The Whales?
To the Whalers' hometown. I don't think that's going to happen. Basically, the Barclays Center, where they play in Brooklyn, released their financials for the next few years, their financial synopses for the next few years. And after the Islanders have an out clause after a few years, whatever, in 2018, 2019. And after that, the Islanders aren't even on the docket anymore. So assuming that there's some back end deal where they're going to leave. So there's all sorts of things in play right now. And I don't know what's going to happen.
What happens if they go and become the Whalers again?
They're not going to become. If they go, they're not going to become the Whalers.
The Whale?
But
twice in a lifetime.
It's a weird kind of thing because if they move to Quebec or to Kansas City or something, I'm done with the NHL and I'm done with the Islanders. But if they move back to Long Island, which is a huge possibility, that would be great. They move to Queens, that would be fine. The Mets owners are trying to get them to move there. But if they move to Hartford, there is something alluring about that to me because the Hartford Whalers moved obviously in the mid-90s. They became the Carolina Hurricanes, and the Whalers are gone. But they have a great tradition in that town for hockey, and they're a miserable fan base too. So it'd be funny to like move the Islanders there, have them become the Connecticut or the Hartford Islanders or something like that, because you know Hartford's not that far from the water, and then we can combine the two miserable fan bases in the one. And we would get the Brass Bonanza, which is still the best goal song and sports and hockey song. So
you're gonna need to rewind that, please. What is the Brass Bonanza?
Do anyone have their They used to play that like after the Whalers would score a goal in like the 80s and the early 90s.
That's fantastic.
Yeah, and it's like
I need more of that.
And that place would like go crazy at the Civic Center, the Hartford Civic Center, or whatever. It'd be funny to get like they don't have any tradition there except for that song. So we could just take that song, put a little Hartford patch on the Islanders jerseys, and then.
I remember when I busted that out one day and you're like, wow, how do you know that song? I was just from NHL 94, 93, 94. But it was just, I don't remember being only attached to them in that game. I think the organist just everywhere played it. Mm-hmm. It's like, whatever, here's a fucking movie.
Yeah, it was a big deal in NHL 94 because obviously there's very limited space. Like they did little Easter eggs for some of the teams. Like at San Jose, they do this.
Chomp, chomp, chomp.
And they actually animated that, like them doing that. And then they put Brass Bonanza only when you played in Hartford. And scored a goal there.
I just can't believe I played in Hartford that much to memorize that song. You know what I mean?
Colin, do you think there's any chance of them looking at like a heat map of the United States and being like, where are the Islanders fans? And then seeing the one little blip in San Francisco?
Yeah, just
like,
me.
We're coming to San Francisco.
Well, they're getting further and further away.
San Francisco,
Suffolk County.
Islanders.
How would that sit with you? What would happen if they came to California? Became the California.
They weren't going to come here. But I mean,
would you still be a fan?
No, if they leave New York and if they don't go to Hartford, I am done.
But what if they came to you? Like they came here.
It's just part of being an Islander.
Juju LeBoo and all of the friends are just living in your apartment.
We've talked about this in the past. We've talked that Juju LeBoo is one of the great all-time NHL players, French Canadian players. Juju LeBoo, great goal scorer, really soft hands. The thing about sports fandom that we've talked about in the past is that sports fandom is supposed to be, in my mind and in the minds of many, an association to where you are from. You know, I always got mystified when someone's like, I'm from Cleveland and I'm a big Blue Jays fan. I'm like, how the fuck is that possible?
Everyone in California I grew up with was a Yankees fan. That wasn't cool.
That doesn't make sense. Unless you have parents or something that came from that place. Like if I have kids, they'll obviously be Jets fans and Islanders fans. And that wouldn't make any sense because we probably won't live there. But generally, so like it would be weird for me to like I associate with the teams that are from where I'm from. I have no interest in any other teams. Everyone's always like, oh, who are you rooting for tonight? I'm like, if the Jets aren't playing, I don't give a fuck who wins. You know, I root against certain teams, of course. So if they moved,
part of that's got to be though just the fact that you were raised with good East Coast values. You were brought up in the world of sports. I feel like if you get a late start on sports, you don't learn it from your family or who you're around. Think of it that way. Like if I was in Chicago, and I mean, that was the thing, you know, like my parents didn't care about sports, so I got a late start for sure. But let's say I never got into the Bears on my own, right, for NFL, but somebody from San Francisco had moved out there, started coming to my school. They liked it. We hit it off for video games, and then I started watching the 49ers with them. Weird stuff like that.
I guess. Don't get
me wrong. I'm with you. You should support where you're from.
As a viewer of ours, I think I was busting his balls, a viewer of ours, one of the shows, I don't remember where it was and when it was. It must have been a year or so ago. Had a Packers hat. I'm like, oh, you're from Wisconsin? He's like, no, I'm from, you know, Texas or whatever. And I'm like,
you knocked him the fuck
fucking
out.
Super convenient that you're a fan of the Green Bay Packers.
Yeah.
Who are like this notoriously awesome team with an amazing fan base and all that kind of stuff. You just got to choose them. You don't get to choose. See, that's what I'm saying. You don't get to choose.
It's true.
They choose you based on where you're from. And I got chosen by just an abomination of teams. Mm-hmm. Just an absolute fucking holocaust of fucking sports teams. Sure. You understand what I'm saying?
One day they'll be good.
Yep. No,
they always say you can pick your nose, you can pick your seat, but you can't pick an asshole. You know what I'm saying, Nick? What's up, everybody? If you didn't know, this is the Game Over Greggy Show each and every week. Four, sometimes five. Best friends gather on this table. What?
You technically can pick an asshole if you wanted to. You can pick at it. You can pick in it. You can do the little hook motion with your finger. Try to go.
Show it to me again.
Like if someone had corn, just dig in there. See what's in there.
Are you getting around the rim?
Just getting in there.
He's bringing a random topic of conversation for your amusement. If you like that, you can head over to patreon.com/kindoffunny and get each and every episode early along with a bunch of exclusive perks and goodies. If you have no bucks to toss our way, no big deal. Head over to youtube.com/kindoffunny where we put the entire show up topic by topic, day by day, until it goes up as one big video and MP3 the following Friday. Tim.
Yeah.
We just got back from Australia.
We did. My first ever international trip. I am now a world traveler. People all around the world.
That's right. Congratulations.
Have given me high fives.
Not only that, but instead of going to like Mexico or Canada, you decided to go to the most faraway place possible.
Down under.
Yeah.
It was real far.
I want to hear all about this. This is exciting for me.
Longest flight I've ever been on.
Exactly. You lied and said you got a lot of work done. You were never working on this trip. Very briefly were you ever working on your airplane seats and doing all this stuff.
You were sleeping for like 8 hours on the flight when I was on the
thing. Awesome.
I used my laptop until the battery died.
But okay.
Yeah, to be fair, the laptop battery dies in like 55 minutes.
No, the new laptop that I bought just for my flight.
Oh, that baller-ass back laptop?
Yeah.
No, I don't believe that for a second. What? I believe the woman next door to us, the woman who was in between us, the large woman in between us.
No, couldn't work then.
Yeah. Oh, you were sat in between, fat chick was sitting in between you guys?
We got.
No fat chicks. It was on the side of the plane.
It was bad. It was
caught his hair. It just says no fat chicks on the side.
It was bad. But just because I had this whole plan where me and Greg were like, all right, Gia was going to come with us and sit in between us, and that wouldn't have mattered at all.
Because Gia's tiny.
Yeah, it would have been fine. But then at the last minute, someone got the seat in between us. Right. So that was sad. By the way,
she was
back,
wearing like a pleather coat, too.
Oh, just so locking all that heat in.
And she had too much perfume on.
Yeah, she kept offering me candy.
I slept.
Was she American or Australian?
I want to say she was,
I don't know,
what they call a Kiwi. She was ending up in New Zealand. She had the accent.
Mm.
And I did not understand why she was connecting from Australia to then get back up to Europe, but that's what she was doing.
She kept giving me candy.
Might be a cheap
and guy. I didn't want it. She's like five times throughout the flight. Mm-hmm. I'm like, I'm good.
She
totally good.
That's always super awkward.
Colin, as you know, because you're documenting me, I can sleep on a plane like nobody's business. I'm very lucky in this thing. Mm-hmm. But usually when I sleep on a plane, because they're domestic flights, 6 hours, whatever. I'll get a few hours there, but then you wake up with that crink in your neck, you know what I mean? You jerk awake, then you're awake, you play some video games, you watch some TV. This one, I decided to treat myself. Kick my heels up. Enjoy the fruits of our success, some would say. And I bought one of them fucking pillow things for your neck, right? And so I get on here, and I'm at, like, I stayed awake for a few hours to try
those,
to...
Those pillows work?
Yeah. Oh, well, okay. For me, it's the missing piece.
They don't work for me, for some reason.
It was the missing piece for me, because I'm always able to sleep, but just not for, you know, it's a 14-hour flight or whatever. Right. I was like, I want to try here. And I was awake maybe the first hour and a half, 2 hours of the flight, then out for...
Majority of
eight,
it.
Six or 8 hours. Yeah. Or something. Grand total, I was awake 5 hours in this plane.
Crazy.
But every the people would come by for beverages, and she would like do this, and like I'm like, what? She's like, do you want? I'm like, no, I'm sleeping. What are you doing? And then the kicker was when the dinner service had come, breakfast in the morning, but they came by with a turkey sandwich snack, like these wrapped up turkey sandwiches, and she like shook me awake and gave it to me. Didn't even hold on to it herself. I'm like, I don't fucking care about this. Go away, woman.
Usually they err on the other side, which is that they won't. Even if he looks like you're half asleep,
no, but I think this is the person sitting in between.
No, this was the person.
This is the woman in the pleather coat.
Oh, so she, not the flight attendant, but the fat chick was taking the things from
she wasn't fat.
A morbidly obese woman sitting in the middle of you guys took the things and then were given.
Exactly.
I misunderstood.
Yeah. But no, to your point, she very much was one of those people that sat down on the plane and then you could see it in her eyes. She brought nothing to do. She had nothing to fucking do on this plane. I have iPad and Vita and books and yeah, exactly. I'm just gonna stare at it. But we have the entertainment system built in. Nothing. Just sitting there and you can see it in her eyes. So I immediately had the headphones on and I was gone. But then on the final thing with breakfast, I popped it off, got my little breakfast tray, and then she started in on it. I was like, I put it back on. I'm not gonna deal with you.
Yeah.
You don't talk to fat chicks. Now the question I have about this particular flight was, what were the accoutrements?
Yeah.
Did you have an outlet? It sounds like you didn't have an outlet.
There was an outlet. Yeah.
So, but you said your laptop died. So you just were, that was the timing in which you were.
At that point, I'm like, I've done enough. I did a lot. It offends me that you said I didn't do work. I did so much.
Because here's what happened.
You had Wi-Fi.
Yeah. Well, if you pay for it.
Which is fine, but yeah, that's awesome because that you have to understand that was rare on international flights, not only even a few years ago.
So we have that. You have all the stuff you brought. You have the entertainment system with the free movies.
Your own individual.
Yep.
I'm trying to just get a picture of it.
I hear you. Okay. Free internet.
Because I've been on all sorts of these fucking international flights.
Free movies, free television, not live, but like on-demand television. It's a very nice plane. You had little power. You had your power.
This is a newer plane.
It had the USB. United's usually fine international.
United is fine international.
It had the USB on the screen, so you could charge your devices or do
that's
whatever.
Nice.
But this is the problem is I think we have unlimited options. So when I nod off, I notice this woman's just been sitting there apparently offering Tim candy. I had the headphones on. She's just standing there just staring at her screen with the map. And I'm like, man, this woman's weird. Whatever.
She's watching the big pixel by pixel movie.
I go to sleep and I wake up. Kevin, I'm going to need the shot at me. I wake up and I look over at Tim and this is what I see. And Tim had gotten possessed by this woman and was now sitting there not using any of his devices, any of the things he brought, staring at the map. Just there was TV. I don't under, no, there were movies, and you were just staring at the map. And she got up, and I'm like, I can feel the misery radiating off you. You're like, this is the worst flight. I haven't been able to sleep. But I don't understand where the breakdown happened, where you're like, I don't even want to watch moving pictures anymore.
Because I hit a point. I mean, I don't deal well with flights. Like, I'm not scared of them. It's nothing like that. I just wish I could sleep, and I can't sleep. So I'm really uncomfortable, and I just don't like it at all. There's no position that feels good. I'm just like, this fucking sucks. And these are tiny little seats too. So when you're sharing with people, and there's like the whole rule of like who gets the armrest and who doesn't.
And this woman was way over it.
My thing is,
I understand
if you're in the middle, I give you the right. You get both armrests. I totally get it. But you don't get to cross them. Like, that's what I don't understand about people. And it's like, it's not like Colin, she was not large enough to need
she was
to go
fat off. But she wasn't that fat is what you're saying. But Jesus,
like, she really didn't need to.
All I'm gonna say is she wasn't able to slam dunk a basketball.
I mean, that's true.
Neither what does that anyone. Mean so
I can't slam dunk a basketball,
and that's why we know
she kept crossing, and even with her legs and stuff, I'm like looking down, I'm like, well, clearly you're on my side of this thing. Like,
also important for this notice, when she got on, first thing she did was take off her shoes.
Which is like, I'm okay with that when you're around friends, when you're around company that you're like, sure. I don't care. Like, if it was you guys, I would do it, whatever. But like, you don't know us. You're really close to us.
Right.
Ugh. And I will give her the benefit of the doubt that it's like, do whatever you can to be comfortable on this hell of a flight. Like, fine.
Yeah.
So yeah, I exhausted my options. I did so much shit. I listened to Hamilton. That shit's fucking good.
Yeah, it is. I listened to a little bit of it. Yeah.
Holy damn.
Yeah, a lot of people have been trying to get
me. I was like, I went into it thinking I'm not going to like this at all.
That's
like,
me.
This is like some mainstream shit, and like it just doesn't sound like a good thing. Started listening to it. 2 minutes in, I'm like, this is really high quality. 10 minutes in, I'm like, how is this quality still going? 2.5 hours later, I'm like, the quality never stopped.
Yeah. Yeah.
It's really good.
A lot of people like Hamilton. I have not given Hamilton a fair shake. I heard one song in my brother's car for 5 minutes, and he was talking over it the entire time, trying to explain to me how good the song was. You know my brother, how?
Yeah.
He's like, what? Wait. And then he starts like singing along with it, and I'm like, this is not the optimal listening experience for this. So I give Hamilton a lot of shit. Also, sometimes it's fun, and Colin, maybe you'll understand this, just to hate on something for the sake of just hating on something that everyone else loves.
I don't know anything about that.
It's just kind of fun sometimes to be the curmudgeon.
Yeah, but with that, I don't think that there's any like one song I'd be like, listen to this. It's really just the experience of the whole story. But I liked it so much that for the flight back, I ended up buying the Hamilton mixtape, which is like a remix thing that they added to the original with a bunch of like,
is that like when they
famous artists and stuff?
When like the girl will sing the song of Moana, but then like they'll hire the real pop star to sing the song, and it's kind like auto-tuned?
Kind of, but it was a bunch of underground people and Common.
Like Moleman?
And Busta Rhymes and like good motherfuckers.
Okay, cool.
Alicia Keys, John Legend, like they did a really good job with it. Anyways, I enjoyed that shit. Listened to a whole bunch of podcasts. I watched Moana.
Oh yeah.
Also,
what'd you think of that?
Fucking dope.
Yeah.
Really good. Anyway, I did a whole bunch of stuff. I played a shit ton of Mario Maker. Played a shit ton of Yoshi's.
See, this is why.
Woolly World.
I think you
and
guys
then for 4 hours stared at the
screen.
Thing
is, I hit a point. I listened to so much music. I hit a point where I'm like, I don't want to do this shit anymore.
You guys just aren't embracing. Now, 16 hours
what
is a lot.
Us.
That's a lot.
I had a great time. Both flights. I loved it.
Well, you mean you sleep like a kitten because you're like a criminal. What's that old saying? Criminal that's already been caught. Sleeps like a baby in jail because he knows he's been on your cot. Some Usual Suspects. Doesn't matter. Totally slaughtered that quote.
I sound like a dirty limerick phrase. Sleeps like a baby because he's been on your cock. I was like, what?
Wow.
Whoa.
I like the long flight though because it gives you an excuse to only do those silly things that you normally like wouldn't do, right? It's guilt free. I'm like, I'm just gonna read this stupid book about Andreas Clay for like 6 hours straight because I can do it because I'm quote unquote incapacitated. I can't really do anything else. Yeah. I love that, and I love the fact that you're like, well, I've only got X amount of movies I can watch, so I guess I'll watch this random episode of fucking Community that's halfway through season 6. That they just got on this plane, which is crazy.
Well, so I brought all my own shit, so I ended up watching the first half of Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles 2 Out of the Shadows.
What do you think of that?
I don't understand how people don't like that. It's a shit
jokes.
Fucking movie, but I mean, it's like, what do you expect?
Save that. My topic's going to dial into something similar to that.
Whatever. It's Ninja, that is as good as
maybe
Ninja Turtles has ever been.
In talks of our Australian trip, we should have spent the first 7 minutes on the plane ride.
Well, it's part of the fun.
Yeah,
I mean, talk to me like that.
It fucking sucked, man. And I couldn't sleep at all. So that was not fun.
One of these days I'm going in hard.
But yeah, I did end up watching a whole bunch of random stuff. And cool. I don't know why we're talking about this now. But
we landed.
Okay, yeah.
So now you're in Australia.
Yeah. Now we are finally in Australia.
And immediately we're in over our heads. Yeah. The first thing we do, we meet our guardian, one of the guardians, lead guardian, who's going to take us to the hotel. We got to wait for all the other RT clowns to show up. No, it was not Aaron Porter from Austin, Texas. Our guardian.
Although there was a bunch of Austin guardians there.
I only met one, I thought.
It was like three of them.
Bernie brought his own. I didn't realize you could do that. Next year we have to demand they fly Aaron up. Uh-huh. But then we went to get coffee because we were going to kill time while we waited for the other RT kids. And we went up there and like they didn't understand what a black coffee is because that doesn't exist there.
Well, so what happened was I walk up to the little cafe and I was just like, hey, can I get a large iced coffee? She looks at me, looks at Greg, and she goes, do you want the slushy coffee? And I was like, mm-mm. Like the iced coffee. She goes, like with ice cubes. And I was like, yes. And she goes, like with ice cubes. And I was like, the fact that you had to ask that twice.
Twice, yeah.
Just let me get a coffee. Can I just
You said yes again. And then you looked at the slushy and you're like, you know what? Maybe, you know what? No, just give me a black coffee.
Just give me a coffee.
The problem where I had already ordered. And I was like, can I get a black coffee? And they just stared at me. And I was like, and they were like, do you mean an Americano? And I'm like, I guess. And they handed me that.
So it was hard. And, you know, we're dumb and ignorant and all that shit.
We are. Anyway. Well, we're bringing freedom in America.
Not knowing what iced coffee and black coffee means doesn't make you dumb and ignorant. Just to throw that out there.
It's a very weird thing because I've been all over the world now in parts of Europe, Asia. Nobody does drip coffee.
They don't.
It's the strangest fucking thing. And you ask for a coffee and they're like, I need more adjectives than that. Like, I need more descriptors than that. What kind of coffee? It's very strange.
It is. I mean, very strange. I come to learn that they don't have coffee there. Like, coffee as we know it is not a thing there. Like, the closest you can get is their espresso with a bunch of hot water.
Yeah, an Americano.
Which is an Americano.
You get a long black,
I know what an Americano is. I don't want that.
Granted,
I want
they're
coffee.
Good. They're actually, it's probably better tasting. It's just different.
Nah, it's
and
just
it seems like it's a lot more steps than necessary.
Well, like the true Americans we are, we want quantity over quality.
Exactly.
And that was the big problem I had is that on Friday I went and did rehearsals with Kojima and then was bumming around the thing and hanging out with Guardians and whatever. But we had drank a bunch of coffee in the morning, chilling out. And when I say coffee, I mean a bunch of long blacks.
Tall, long blacks.
I was sucking down long blacks like nobody's business.
Please tell me you can actually go to a barista and be like, I'd like one very long, very hot,
very
black.
Hard, throbbing. Black
to put in my mouth.
Yeah, exactly. You can say that, sure. Good night, mate.
So close.
There was a lot of names.
Oh my God. I at one point had a minute and a half conversation with some guy. There was like 15 mates in it. I was like, I don't know how you do it.
Yeah.
But I drank so many of them, I had a splitting headache by the end of it. I had to go home. I was over caffeinated because I was drinking them like normal coffee. And they aren't normal coffee.
They aren't normal coffees. No. So that was like our first experience. Then we saw McDonald's, which they lovingly refer to as Macca's. They have a whole bunch of different shit than we have.
Mm-hmm.
They have loaded fries, which are just love them.
I know you're getting to this, but is this where you ate the kangaroo?
No.
Okay.
No.
I want this story.
So I ate the kangaroo. It was just a little bit. Like there at one of the mixer events we were at. We got to play a Nintendo Switch, hang out with Kojima, and eat some kangaroo.
Was it like a skewer of kangaroo, or did they actually give you
a
steak?
It was a spoon of like ground beef kangaroo.
Like a tartare kangaroo.
And nobody knew what they were eating. And then it turned out it was kangaroo.
Is kangaroo, I'm asking you guys this like you're a cultural fucking attaché. Is kangaroo... Like, is that meat like a delicacy or is it just a staple of their diet?
It's like bison and shit like that.
Oh, okay,
like,
so just, people eat it, but it's not necessarily, you're not going to walk into a store and find a ton of kangaroo.
Yeah, yeah. I was hanging out with Katie, Jack's wife, Jack Patillo from Achievement Hunter.
Okay.
And she's legit Australian. So like she was kind of like running us through the whole thing.
That's fun.
She was like, oh no, like, because he came up to me and asked me if I wanted to try some kangaroo and I had a moment where I'm looking around.
Yes,
and I'm like,
yes.
Is this a trick? Like, are you trying to get me to eat this nation's fine
mascot. National animal.
I'm not sure what it's called. I was like, I ain't trying to like, you know, disrespect no one. Katie's like, no, you gotta try it. I'm like, all right. And I did, and I was like, whatever. I don't really like bison and stuff.
It's whatever.
I like, you know, cow.
Yeah.
I'm gonna stick to the cow.
But
I did get to eat the kangaroo, didn't need to fight one. I had a lot of beef with kangaroos going into this trip, so I'm happy that it ended with me victorious, eating that son of a bitch.
I'm very glad you didn't choose to fight a kangaroo, largely because Kevin wasn't there and you don't fight for yourself.
I think
that would have been a kind of mistake on your part.
It would have been bad, but luckily I didn't need to actually fight. I just needed to eat.
Good.
If you haven't been to Australia before, there is just as many koalas and kangaroos and boomerangs as you'd think. Every store we walked by had one on it. I was just like, God damn, you guys are going so far into this.
They know what they're in.
Yeah.
They know what they like.
And I appreciated it, you know? And there was a lot of kangaroos and koalas hanging out with eagles. And I'm like, wow.
Now, to be clear, he's talking about stuffed animals.
They were, of course.
We weren't seeing real kangaroos.
No, unfortunately.
Every store is like,
koala store, kangaroo store.
I mean, pretty much it was that, and then Uggs. There was so many Uggs.
Oh my God! Yeah. Did you know Uggs are from Australia?
I think I did.
Because once you go to Australia, they will shove that shit down your throat and let you know every fucking store.
They had every Ugg store has a giant Ugg in front of it with a kangaroo in it.
That's and I'm fantastic.
Like, these guys, man, it was fun. Like, they were really, like, crazy and shit. There was a lot of weird shit in Australia that I, like, it was very similar to here. Like,
we kept get saying there, it was Seattle.
And I'm like, this is Seattle. Like, this is exactly like Seattle. With minor differences that only stood out so much because they were the only things different. They drive on the other side of the road, is really off-putting and scary.
Very scary when you're crossing the street.
Exactly. Because I'm like, it always feels like the cars are coming at you.
That's it was bad. More odd because when we were walking on the sidewalk. Walking on the sidewalk, Tim and I kept walking as you should as an American.
On the right.
On the right. Yeah. And then people kept walking. And we're like, oh, right, we're in the wrong country. Because I was getting mad. You're violating the social contract. Mm-hmm. And then I realized, no, it's different here.
We're the assholes.
Sorry, mates.
We were big assholes. Like, I'll just put that out there.
Were we?
I feel like we were.
No. Yeah. Here's the thing that was the best about Australia. And it took me embarrassingly long to figure this out. But on Saturday, after RTX Sydney, the Kind of Funny community had a Kind of Funny meetup where they had organized on their own. Nick got them all together. Not this Nick. Nick down there. And he had...
Nick's is... Oh, no. Nothing. There's another Nick in that group. It's the son of a bitch.
Okay. We'll get to that in a second, I guess.
Mike and Pepsi and shit. It was a whole...
Okay. Wow. Okay. Well, they had done their own thing off the Facebook group and all that jazz to meet up at the Hard Rock Cafe. And they had booked reservations and then more people kept getting at it. So they met at the bar and like it was like 70 or 80 kids at the bar. And then it got boiled down to like, I think 50 was it or something like that. We're going to eat dinner. Yeah. And so... when we went in, they all went fucking crazy. And so the entire Hard Rock stopped to look what was happening because we surprised them. They didn't know we were coming, except for Nick and a couple other folks. And so we walk in and the place goes, it just erupts. And all the normals start looking over like, what the fuck's going on? We go over and celebrate with them, blah, blah, blah. And then it was time to move over there. So I think it was Nick's like, move to the table! And like screaming at the top of his lungs. And I'm like, oh, fuck. We've done this before. We've had meet and greets. We get in trouble with people all the time. It happens here in America. When I go to Canada, I get told I'm too loud all the time. They're not a loud people. And so America's a loud country. And then I'm like, I don't know how this is going to go. We went there. We sat at the tables. Nick started screaming again for everybody to sit down if they had a thing. And I'm like, oh, shit, here. And sure enough, servers came over. Then they started yelling, not in an angry fashion. He's like, what do you want? What soda do you want? Like, and I was like, oh my God, this is a country that screams all the time like me. And nobody, it's just normal and you're totally fine. I think we blended in more than most here.
Well, in those terms, I think you're right.
So where were we assholes?
I don't know. Just in general. I don't know. I felt like one, but that's just
I feel like you always feel that way when you're traveling in a foreign country, though, because you're just not used to the way things are working. And you always have that like that moment where you realize you've either overstepped a bound or you need to ask a question that normal people don't need to ask. Like the coffee thing where you're like, explain to me how your coffee works.
Yeah, exactly. So there was like, a lot of moments like that. How do you not know this? So the no tipping thing was weird to me. Only in it felt weird every time, but it felt really weird when there was clearly a tipping option.
Right.
And I'm like, if you don't want the tip, don't give me the option of, do you want to tip? Cause then the other thing about Australia is there's some law or rule where they can't take your card away. So they need to bring a little machine to you.
They bring the machine
and do it there. So like there was one time I got like really confused. Like she handed me the machine, put my card in and she goes, what account's it under? And I'm like, that's not a question that makes sense to me.
Yeah, I don't understand that.
I was like, Tim Gettys? And she was just like, no, like what account's it under? I'm like, Citibank. what counts it under? She just kept asking me. I'm like, I don't know what you mean. I was just, she's
I've
like,
and then she was like,
debit or credit? I'm like, oh, credit. That's a weird way to ask that question. Yeah, but you know, whatever. Credit.
Start with debit or credit. There's only two options.
Super weird. Anyway, I say that, and then she starts running it, and then it says, do you want a tip? And then it was the like normal like 10, 15, 20 thing. And I'm standing there and I kind of look at her. She's standing behind me and I wanted to ask the people I'm with, like, am I supposed to here and not in the other places? And they're all having a conversation. I'm like, oh, fuck. So I just hit no and I felt really bad. But I assume that's what was supposed to happen.
I wanted to jump in and say, I think that these things are designed to not prey on Americans or people that do tip, but it's like in Japan, it's dishonorable to offer a tip or to leave a tip. But I think in Australia, they don't do that, but they hope you do. Mm-hmm. Here, you have to. So I think that those are like the strata, in my opinion.
But that was a,
if she was watching me, I would have given
complicated situation, for sure.
What was great for me is I kept getting credit cards declined.
Oh, yeah.
Because like the auto fraud shit would be going off. So I'm like, I got this, guys, and hand over the card. And they'd be like in front of friends or fans. And it was like, it's declined.
Yeah, the Citibank's really protective of that. I get that every time I travel. Time I travel.
You gotta call them.
Cars are really weird there. There's no Priuses.
When they travel in a pack.
There's none. I didn't see any, which blew my mind. There was this really interesting car that I feel like Kevin would really like that I kept seeing that is like the first front of it looks like a car, but then the back's a pickup truck. Yeah. I'm like, what the hell is
not,
that?
Now,
like
not, not a Camaro. Yeah.
El Camino.
Yeah, El Camino. Sure, sorry.
Yeah, it was very
not
interesting.
Like
was
more, not exactly like
not a
this
Camaro
is,
either.
It's not a Camaro for sure.
Well, for sure,
El Camino though, it's not either because it had the body of a pickup truck. It could be a pickup truck, but it had a car front, which is weird. More importantly, we kept getting in taxis and Uber vans or whatever
with
that
the
had
front
the vans facing each other, the seats facing each other.
Oh, that's always fun.
But it was like they weren't far enough away, so your knees would always be touching. Mm. It was like that's poor design, and seatbelts also go the wrong way.
Ah, yes.
And this. And
drive around the wrong side of the car.
Yeah, it's like there's a lot of just like things are backwards and crazy. Yeah.
Mm. And the wheels are on top of the car.
Yeah. Oh my God.
It runs on blood.
It was nuts. This has been well documented now, but the toilet's there. It's a fucking lie. It's a fucking myth. The shit does not go the other way. The water just pours from all angles, man. Yeah.
But isn't this just because it's kind of toilet we were using?
I used modern 23 different toilets, Greg, in my journey there. 23. I counted. There was a bunch of places I tried the toilet. Didn't even need to pee. I just went in to flush just to see what's up. Every single one. Flushing from all sides.
Now
every single toilet. Totally different. America, we got that bowl with the water in it. Here, we got this freaking... Or not there. There, it's like a very shallow bowl, and then like just this hole of despair where there were things go down there, and then the water just fucking
pushes
they have it.
Do you encounter the two different types of flushes?
Oh yeah,
the most annoying thing.
For number, what do you mean saving water? Number one,
saves
two.
Water. It's great. It's very economical.
Have you seen
very
the ocean?
Environment.
We have plenty of water.
That's what I'm saying.
Well, I think just flush the
poops
out there.
What I don't like is when I go to number two, and I have to see the remnants of that traced down the entire bowl because there's no fucking water in the thing.
But then you also kind of feel accomplished.
Well, I mean, I always do. I don't know about anyone else, but I always take a look just to make sure everything's on par.
I like to think of the maid coming in there and be like, oh my God, what did this guy do to this
thing?
I'm
sure it's not the only time they've seen that, but every time they see you, they're probably just awestruck.
Here's the thing you're bringing up. The toilets don't go, whatever. The main disturbing thing was that how hung up bars and restaurants and hotels and everybody else are on the trough still. The urinal, and not a trough like I kept talking to fans about it. Not a trough that I'm used to, because here in America, usually like a stadium, you go to a stadium, you're gonna have the trough there, which is raised. This was just the wall to the ground thing, and then this weird grate. It was a step up and then a grate. And so when I was at the Hard Rock and found that, I was peeing from behind the step, like angling it in, and then other people came in and got up on the grate, and I was like, oh, that's how you do it? There are fans, so I started joking about it. I climbed up there, and piss is splashing back off the wall on your feet, and I'm like,
also,
this is disgusting. Why are we standing this close to it?
More than once, I found that the troughs had like a reflective wall. And I'm like,
look at your dick.
I could see other everyone's willy if I was looking, you know?
Well, I mean, they're just a more cultured people about that. I mean, I was talking to people while I was peeing about the way.
I mean, who doesn't take a look at another man's dick every once in a while?
No, but I mean, they made it too easy. You need the fun in it or else it's not worth it. Like, this was just.
Oh,
like,
you need to do the side glance thing?
Yeah, the side glance is cool. But, like, not like this. Not like this.
All right, what else?
The trees on sidewalks. Mm-hmm. You know, normally we have the little, like, either, like, ground rubble or whatever, but, like. Or like just dirt.
Sure.
They have, it's just like, it's solid. It's like a bunch of pebbles that are put together and it's like motherfuckers are like skateboarding over and shit. And I was like, that's weird. And I just found it. That was one of my observations.
Good observation.
I like the different things.
Yeah.
That was really different. Everyone says legend. They call people legends. It's like, it's more common than mate.
He's a legend, mate.
Like,
can understand most
like,
people.
Like, oh, you're
saying.
A legend. Yeah.
Yeah. Like, it's like when you're talking to somebody, like, okay, yeah.
Good. Menus were all right, and I could understand them until we went to the fancy restaurant.
Yeah.
And it was just like,
oh, everything's in grams?
These words. Yeah. Like, we're
you
trying to order
50 grams
steak,
of steak, 1,000 like, grams. I don't know what the fuck's happening. Is this, is it coming in a dime bag? What's going on?
A lot of words that I'm like, I don't get
why
this.
Why wouldn't they use ounces?
Why wouldn't they?
Yeah.
Because only us, we do that. Yeah. We're America. We're free.
We use the imperial measurement system.
Sorry.
By the way, that's what I've said that before, but I love in the United States how we just absolutely refuse to do anything the rest of the world does in terms of measurement. It is the fucking funniest thing ever. I love it. It's so great. Yeah, the fuck's a mile?
I don't know. Remember when we crashed the Mars lander because
we converted? Yeah. It's good stuff. It's fun. It's fun times. She collided that. Millions and millions of dollars right into the red planet at 25,000 miles an hour.
It's fine. Hey, it got there, didn't it?
Everyone was talking about the spiders and how we had to be careful of the spiders and stuff. Luckily, didn't see a single spider in my time in Australia.
You didn't see one.
I know.
They saw me. They ate a couple.
But I did hear about a lot of them, and apparently they have like the most famous spider over there is the huntsman spider. And I'm like, don't call a spider a huntsman spider. That's a fucking bad name.
What's it
do? Find me a huntsman spider, Kevin. Thank you.
Yeah, that shit's fucking trouble.
Also, I audio
a,
Google.
Got my little list. I guess that's it. That's all. Oh, no, the chlamydia.
Okay. Is this the koala back?
Yeah, so koalas thing? Have chlamydia. I've never heard the word chlamydia more than the last week in Australia. Like,
oh no.
Fuck that thing.
No, no.
Fuck that thing.
No.
No.
Now, what I hear is they're quite gentle.
Yeah, fuck that shit, man.
Kevin,
yeah,
can you bring it back up on the big screen so we can see that?
Is it biting? We can't see it. It's so small.
I don't like this. I don't like this at all.
Oh, yeah, he's biting. All right. He's pinching.
Fuck that thing.
These things are unnatural, dude.
I really don't like that. Yeah.
I'm sorry.
Anyway, all the koalas have chlamydia, so you can't touch them at the zoo. Like, there's only certain koalas that you can be friends with, and the other ones are like assholes, and we'll just straight up give you chlamydia.
Now, do you have to fuck them to get the chlamydia?
No, there was a lot of talking about fucking koalas.
See, this was the thing, though, and this was people were saying that originally, and why? And I was like, you can't get chlamydia from a koala if you're not fucking it. And they were like, no, scratches and stuff. And I was like, that doesn't sound right. But that's what people were saying after they went to the zoo.
Yeah, but Australia doesn't have schools and shit.
Panda Musk was like, no, that's not, you can't get koala from you can't get koala chlamydia.
Guys, real quick question. How are these koala bears getting chlamydia? Did anyone talk about it?
They fuck a lot.
Really? At some point, a human fucked a koala, probably back when it was a penal colony.
That's why they call it a penal colony.
And then they got penal diseases.
I did meet a koala at the airport.
Right.
We don't have a picture to show you yet, but... it'll come at some point.
It's just
some dude in the koala suit.
The thing about it is, Tim, it was a person in the koala suit, Colin, and had kids surrounding it. And then Tim was like, I'm going to take a photo. And you take a photo of me, Greg, and I'll point at it, and we'll put some distance behind it. And I'll put, this is as close as I could get. The caption will be like, this is as close as I get because they all have chlamydia. And the koala is constantly turning, so it really just looks like Tim can't get close to children or is really excited to be this close to a bunch of children because there's a bunch of small kids gathered around. Tim's like,
Those small kids. You know what else there's a lot of? Roosters. It's the year of the rooster. Which is a Chinese thing. And goddamn Australia loves them damn roosters. They were everywhere.
Australia's super Asian. Didn't expect
super
that.
Super Asian.
Did not expect
just
that.
Just like San Francisco Asian.
Yeah.
Like,
that's a lot of Asian.
Probably why we felt so at home.
Yeah, exactly. It was like, it was crazy though. Like, I think we saw more roosters than kangaroos.
Yeah, probably.
And that's impressive because there was a lot of kangaroos.
Sure, that's true. That's
not
true.
Real kangaroos. I didn't see any real kangaroos.
You didn't see any real kangaroos.
Which is really upsetting. Sure. And then what was the other little dude, the quokka?
I don't know. The thing that everybody gave me Joey Noel is to bring home. Yeah. I'll tell you what. It used to be bring stuff to Colin, and then it became bring stuff to Kevin, and now it's bring stuff to Joey Noel.
Yeah.
I'm fucking bringing home goddamn quokkas or whatever the hell they are. Quokkas. They're stuffed in my bag.
Yeah.
Joey Noel better pick up all these fucking things.
Australia was awesome, though. Honestly, I think I kept saying this. It was the best convention I think I've ever been to.
Yeah.
And just everyone there was super nice. I think a lot of
it was really well run.
Yeah. Everything about it was great.
There's a quokka, I guess.
Bring the quokka.
Holy Jesus.
Look at this cute motherfucker.
It's adorable. It's like a psychopath. Are you kidding me?
That thing was like crazy. They don't have chlamydia. That's why they're stoked.
Yeah, they're like, oh, we're good.
They fuck without repercussion.
Yeah, they do.
But
no, the show was great. The panel was awesome. Yeah, because it wasn't even a panel. Awesome. It was a stand-up. It was somewhere between a panel and Kinda Funny Live, which was awesome.
Yeah, exactly. So by the time this video goes up, it should be live. I'm planning to put it up this Friday. So you will be able to see the panel. Go check it out on youtube.com/kindafunny. Kev, can you pull up some of the pictures so we can just go through them real quick down there?
He's got all them quokkas. Give me a second. While that happens, have you told either of them your story? From the bridge?
Oh, them? No. Yeah. No, I didn't.
I think you should tell them. I mean, I know it's part of the panel.
It's part of the panel, but long story short, I don't have phone service.
Don't worry, Kev. You keep doing your thing and don't interrupt. We'll be fine.
I didn't have phone service in Australia at all, unless I had Wi-Fi. So the first night, Greg was really tired for whatever reason.
I had the headache from
the coffee.
Colin, I'll tell you what. I put so many long blacks inside me on Friday. I just had to go home and rest. I had a headache. I was dehydrated.
You took a lot of long blacks to the head.
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
What you did.
Well, mainly to the mouth.
Yeah, to the mouth.
Honestly.
But by virtue of that, by proxy of that, right to the forehead.
Oh, sure.
Right?
Okay.
When you were finished long black, it basically finished right to the forehead.
The long blacks did finish in my forehead.
Wow, that's crazy.
Forehead. Man. Is that a thing?
It's just because the problem is they're making like a penis and ejaculation.
No, I get it, but who aims for the forehead?
Oh, who doesn't?
Well, I think you aim for the mouth and it goes, ba-ba-ki.
You aim, and so it goes.
You aim
forever.
And pray. Spray and pray.
Spray and pray.
It's not a Scud missile.
Anyways, I had to get home by myself because Greg left me and I ended up staying at the mixer for way too long. So by the time I was leaving, I didn't know anybody, and it, like, so all the Roosie people were gone, and I couldn't use my phone to Google Map or whatever. So I was like, fuck, I need to just talk to people and find my way home. So I leave and I start asking people like where the hotel is. Everyone's super nice giving me directions, but it was like a weird ass way to get there. There's this long ass bridge, and I start walking across it, and I'm like, I need to ask somebody for directions, but like, I don't want to ask like any like young woman, cause I don't want to like have her think I'm like coming on to her or whatever. Right. There's all these like rules in my head. I'm like, I gotta be careful about this. I saw a couple and I'm like, oh, I'm gonna ask you. First off, I saw a couple that was kind of funny best friends. They were awesome. They guided me the right way. But as I kept going, I got lost again. So I saw another couple and I went up to them and started, and I asked them, I was like, hey, excuse me, like, do you know where the Swiss Hotel is or whatever? And like, oh yeah, you just go this way. And like, oh, we're walking that way. Do you wanna walk with us? I'm like, yeah, sure. We all start walking. And they're just telling me all these stories and stuff. And I'm like, they're funny ass people. And I'm like, oh, cool. This is great. And we end up talking for like 30 minutes or so. We're in the middle of a story. We get to the other end of the bridge. And then they're not done telling some whatever story she was saying. I don't even remember what it was. And she was like, oh, do you want to go grab a drink real quick? And then we can like direct you the right way. I'm like, oh, yeah, sure. We head over to some bar. We're just chilling, just me and this couple. And I get a drink, everything's cool. And then like they finish the story, and then out of nowhere, it was like a fucking switch just going on. She goes, hey, he thinks your accent's cute. And I was like, thank you. It was really weird. And then she goes, I also think your accent's cute.
Yes.
I was like, thank you.
Yes.
And she was like, no, like, are you interested in this? And I was like, oh, no, thank you. Can you please just
were they like, now what level of good looking were we talking about?
They were good looking, not great looking.
Good looking enough so that if Gia wasn't in the picture, you'd be like, all right, I'm going to fuck this guy in front of his girlfriend. Right now. Like, how good looking are we talking about?
I'm going to fuck this guy in front of his girlfriend.
No,
worth it.
But, I mean, I was like, it was a weird situation because like, I've never been like, came on to by a guy before, you know? Is that the right phrasing for that?
Yeah, absolutely.
But anyways, yeah, it was like I felt awkward. Like I was like kind of embarrassed, which is weird.
It's very flattering though. That's good.
But yeah, but then they just directed me home and I just went home.
You're like, cool. They're like, oh, by the way, the hotel's right there.
Yeah,
like,
God, essentially.
And then what was Gia's reaction to all this? That's the one thing I haven't heard.
Oh, I mean, it's just Gia. She was just like.
Well, Gia strikes me as the type to be like, oh, that's very, how lovely of them.
Well, I mean, she was interested in it, but like, I mean, it was, yeah, like, it's so number? Normal. Is everything so normalized with that girl where it's just like, whatever.
She's seen too much.
But I mean, yeah, it definitely caught me off guard. I didn't see it coming. I was a little drunk. Like leaving the place, so it was like, but I still didn't see it coming. Right.
Let's look at nuts. Photos then. Where you want to start?
Yeah. So, are they prep, Kev?
Right now,
no, it doesn't matter. I just want to talk about it. So this is the panel.
Yeah.
This is when Greg did his super awesome Sandman entrance.
Right. Improving on what I did at PAX West.
Yeah.
After a lot of trial and error at this panel.
Yeah, unfortunately, this is not in the panel because this had to happen after the stream, but we will be uploading this video separately at a later date. It's going to take a little more time because I need to get footage. If you were at the panel and have footage, please email me it or get it to me somehow. I'm sure you'll figure it out.
Okay.
That's me and you taking couples picture in front of
the Sydney Bridge, right? We're outside the Sydney Opera House.
Yeah.
Pandemus took us there on Monday. This was we talked about it. I kept saying how you like Australia? I kept saying it's America with accents. It's great. You know what I mean? I blend right in. It feels like Seattle. Great. This was the first time for me where I was walking. I'm like, oh, this feels like a different country. This is cool. The water, the bridge, people walking over the bridge, the Sydney Opera House you've seen a million times.
Yeah, it's pretty.
Yeah.
Next up, Kev. There we go, Sydney Opera House.
That's part
of the tourist thing.
Yeah, yeah.
Mm. I liked it. Go for it.
What's better? Having a display down there or up there?
Bigger's better. I can't really see what's going on down there.
Bigger is definitely better.
You can see there. Yeah.
This is good. Yeah. This is better.
It's out of focus, but it doesn't matter.
Yeah, it's fine. It's better. That was the community dinner that we did. They planned it all. We
this
just
is Nick
showed
right
up.
Here.
Yeah. Fantastic people. Great group of kids. This is the signing line that we did. Very healthy signing line.
Autograph line one, yeah.
Mm-hmm. These were just people that didn't make it into the signing, so they were just standing on the outside.
Yeah, Jesus.
I appreciate that. Quite the crowd.
Good.
There's our boy, Pat. You might know him from being at this table.
Back in the day, he came through.
Back at the
the
old studio.
I did the exact same thing where he came up and started talking to me and get an autograph, and I just totally, it just did not register who he was because he looks different.
His hair is different, he had a fucked up leg, so like he was walking with the cane. I'm like, what the hell?
Yeah.
He was getting his For Honor on. So now this year, you can't really tell. But this kid comes up to us and he goes, do you know what I'm cosplaying as? And we're like, I'm sorry, no.
Yeah,
no. Not the slightest clue. He's like, I'm in the PE outfit from Kind of Funny, the animated series. And he was wearing the shorts.
Yeah, there's a full body shot somewhere. Yeah, yeah. He had the socks pulled up. Yeah, yeah, yeah.
But anyway, yeah, like, it fucking happened,
Nick. That is amazing.
It happens. Yes. People cosplay it as us.
Just keep doing it long enough. You know what I mean? That's all that really matters.
Oh, yeah.
This guy right here. In a Sean Finnegan Likes Hiking shirt.
One of four sold.
Yeah.
One of four sold.
So I love that shirt. We got to bring that shirt back.
Nope. Nobody bought
it. That was impressive. Go forward. A freaking Q&5 fan that I found out in Australia. Was a big, big fan of that. This is more pictures of Greg coming down, looking like a legend.
This is definitely one of the ones from John, our photographer. Yes. We're going to have all those up. He took more than, I think it was 1,200 shots. We're putting up 430 or something like that. By the time you see this, we'll have tweeted it out a bunch of times.
His shit's running good. Is that it, Kev?
No.
Me spitting out beer thing. Yeah. That's the end shot of our panel of everybody that was there.
Awesome.
Amazing theater, amazing crowd, filled to the brim.
Yeah, it was really cool. Any more picks? That was me and Greg playing the Nintendo Switch. There's a game where you have to eat a sandwich, and it got real intense.
Yeah, it looks like you're eating pussy.
Yeah, it does. Yeah. It does.
You, I mean, you uploaded
a video on your Instagram of me eating it.
Yeah.
And I ate it well. That's Greg after he beat me in some
now,
samurai
what's
game.
Important here? No, because this was one of the interstitials we did for the Rooster Teeth stream, where they put us over the Nintendo booth and we filled like 5 or 6 minutes or something. We played a bunch of different Switch games. The first one was 1-2 Switch, the samurai game.
Wait, are you standing inside of a black guy's head?
Correct.
What the fuck is going on with this?
I'm
going
to get to it. So okay. The first was the samurai game.
Yeah.
In which, after we got the hang of it, you challenged me for the Kind of Funny Nintendo World Championship. You beat me for it, mm-hmm. which you've never done. You beat me to win the Nintendo World Championship. True. Then we went next door to the sandwich eating thing, mm-hmm. and I beat the fuck out of you there. I took the championship back.
You did.
So that's me standing on top of one Nintendo speakers in there, celebrating with the fans that had gathered to watch us outside.
Yeah, he crushed it. That was quite the experience.
And then we're back
to that. But okay, so the last thing I want to show for you guys to see, this is my favorite moment of the panel that wasn't Greg's intro. So Greg brought up one of the kids and was just like, you think you know who Panda Musk is? And he started explaining who he thought Panda Musk, like, he was like, I Panda Musk is from Australia. I've deduced this, whatever, figured it all out. And Greg's like, do you think you could find Panda Musk in the crowd? Now, for those of you at home that don't know this, Panda Musk, the guy that does all of our art, the Game Over Greggy show intro.
The painting will be right here. Stuff.
Yeah, yeah, the painting and all that.
There it is.
There it is. All that. But his identity is a secret.
Sure.
So he doesn't want to be known or whatever. So what we did is we wanted to see if Panda Musk would reveal himself in the crowd,
mm-hmm.
and this is what happened. Hold on, okay, before you play it, for the audio so these guys can hear, I'm gonna play
please
it
tell
on,
me like
on this as well.
40 we're people gonna try stood up and like, I'm it. Panda Musk. I'm Panda Musk.
It's like to tell the truth.
Yeah.
All right.
No, wait, hold on. Let me just center this a little bit. Ready?
Yeah.
3, 2.
Get it?
Go for it.
I am Panda Musk.
That's awesome. That is amazing.
I'm Greg Miller. This is kind of
It was
funny.
An awesome moment.
It was pretty great.
That's great.
So yeah, RTX Sydney was great. Australia was great. Yeah, you did. You blew it.
Well, right. I guessed it because you guys aren't original.
It's true.
Beyond, we used to call that.
Oh, hi. I didn't see you come in. I was just subscribing on iTunes to the Kind of Funny Morning Show. You can do the same on podcast services around the globe. I just have an iPhone. Or you can go to soundcloud.com/Kind of Funny Morning Show. That's right, ladies and gentlemen. The formerly known Colin and Greg Live, now Kind of Funny Morning Show, is a podcast. We listen to you. 2017 is all about communication. So we put it up as YouTube videos. I'm sure you've seen. Subscribe, youtube.com/Kind of Funny. Or get the Kind of Funny Morning Show as a podcast on soundcloud.com/Kind of Funny Morning Show. Your iDevice, if you're a dork like Kevin, your Android thing. Why do you even get podcasts on your thing? You say to the watch, I need a podcast? What happens? You just shrug. You don't listen to podcasts.
I go to SoundCloud and download
them. Oh, okay. You're one of those guys.
What do you mean one of those guys?
I mean, like what? You can't, there's no subscription, there's nothing. Ladies and gentlemen, it's a podcast. It would mean a lot if you went and subscribed to it. And you might say, I watch it live on Twitch, and to which I just say, just subscribe. Who cares? And it's just a number. Subscribe. Hi, it's Greg. Good morning show. SoundCloud. Kevin.